So this is our senior design project, and my name is Dallas. Sleep apnea is a huge problem in today's world, and sleep apnea is a disorder which breathing stops during sleep repeatedly, and a common symptom of sleep apnea is snoring. And so we thought, as a senior design team, if you analyze someone's snoring patterns throughout the night, you can reverse engineer their sleep apnea results to see if they might be likely to have sleep apnea. So then we looked into current solutions, and we found two basic points from those. Either they were too expensive, or they disrupted someone's sleep. So if you go into sleep study, then you might have all these sensors on you. You might be sleeping in a hospital bed. A lot of things are going wrong where you might not get a valuable night's sleep. And so we took that into consideration for our design. We wanted to make something that was inexpensive, and we also wanted to make something that would not disrupt someone's natural sleep patterns, as well as implement a smartphone application to use Bluetooth, and that would eliminate another wire that would be unnecessary for our project.
So our solution, we decided it needed to be wearable. We didn't want to have a full separate apparatus that resembled on someone's bedside, because we wanted it to be also very accurate. And we found the best results were included whenever the microphone was as close to their face as possible. We wanted it to be non-intrusive, so like the sleep studies and the sleep apnea test kits include wires and sensors like all over the top of their body. And we felt like this disrupted someone's sleep to a point that you wouldn't get an accurate night of sleeping results. So we wanted this to be as non-intrusive as possible, so that way you could at least sleep normally and then get accurate results. We wanted it to be inexpensive. A lot of these sleep studies go for about $600 to even close to $1,000, and the sleep apnea test kits are at least $250. So we wanted ours to be affordable so that anybody could use this, not necessarily someone who, like the doctor says, you need to go have a sleep study done, but maybe someone who's just curious whether they have any kind of symptoms related to sleep apnea. Then we needed this to be rechargeable. For this to work normally, it has to be able to go through a full night's sleep. So we planned and designed this to work for 8 hours of battery life. Through our testing and results, we've been able to achieve at least 10 hours of battery life, which is pretty good. We doubt anyone's sleeping longer than 10 hours in the first place. The device is then rechargeable. You can plug it back in, it takes just a few hours to fully charge up our battery then. Our battery is a 500 milliamp hour, and it generally, again, lasts for at least 10 hours. So we needed the results to be accurate, because you could just record sound, like with your cell phone, for example, but we found that there was a lot of issues, and this very much depends on what type of phone you had. So we have a amplifier and a bandpass filter attached to a microphone on the sensor that records the snoring data and then sends it over Bluetooth to our mobile application. Our filter basically, I think, cuts off at 3.2 kilohertz in the max range, and then our low-pass side of that is basically implemented through our microphone, which doesn't take anything below 10 hertz. So again, the accuracy here is then amplified so that we can send a strong signal back over to our application. We wanted this to be adaptive. We wanted to be able to detect and filter out if there's any unnecessary noise or data going on. So for example, like if you have a television on or you sleep with a fan, we don't want that to influence the results of the system. Then we also wanted the application to be user-friendly. So looking at our mobile application, you first scan through and you will find the listed Bluno, which is the Arduino that we chose to use for this project. You will then attach that to the application, and then you will first take about 10 measurements, so it's about 10 seconds where it just reads the total noise level in the room, and it considers that basically just the background noise that's gonna be happening while you're sleeping. So then it can filter that out, so if you sleep with a fan, for example, it won't consider that and spikes them while you're sleeping. So we have two scores attached to this app. We have a snore score and the sleep apnea score. Corey's gonna touch into those here in a little bit. But basically, our application, after it sends the data to the phone and the Arduino itself, will help calculate these scores for us. So we implemented this using Android Studio for our mobile application. We store the results using a SQLite database. And then again, we send Bluetooth signals over the top of Arduino.
So the way that the algorithm works is that the microphone takes in audio data, an audio waveform, and the Arduino analyzes the the waveform, the signal waveform, and the signal envelope, so the volume of the signal waveform. It first takes into account, does a DFT transform of the audio signal to determine whether or not the frequency of the signal is within a certain range. So the range that we picked was about 500 to 1.5 kilohertz, because that's typically the range of frequency that is associated with snoring waveforms. Then it looks at the signal envelope. It determines if it's above a certain threshold for a certain amount of time, because typically snoring would only occur, one pulse of snoring would only occur for about 0.5 to 2.5 seconds. So it checks for that. And then thirdly, it checks for the periodicity of those pulses. So each pulse, if it is a snoring waveform, it should be periodic and at a certain frequency. So the Arduino algorithm, it takes those three parameters, feeds them into an algorithm, and then that spits out a snoring score, which is from 0 to 100%. 0% means that you're not snoring, 100% means that the app can almost certainly determine that you are snoring. Now, to determine the apnea score, the application waits to see if your snore score goes above 80%, because if it goes above 80%, it can accurately determine that your breathing patterns can be associated with your snoring patterns. So if there's a lapse in your snoring pattern for a certain amount of time, that is a good indication of sleep apnea, because it most likely means that you have stopped breathing for a certain amount of time. So as you have more and more lapses in breath, the apnea score goes up. And as you snore more, the apnea score will continue to go down. Now, these two measurements are plotted throughout time as you sleep. So at the end of your sleeping session, you can hit stop, and the app will plot out your snore score and your apnea score throughout the time that you were asleep. So that way you can go back and look and see, you know, at what points were you snoring, at what points did you have sleep apnea. And you can store these records to be viewed later from the home screen. So that way, if you were to want to check and see if you snore, if you have sleep apnea, or you want to show even the results to a doctor to show proof for reason for a sleep study or something more advanced, you could. You could show them the records and, you know, say that, hey, I'm snoring. I feel like there are problems with my health. You could also use this as a way to track your health in general. So say you determine that you're snoring through the application, you can go back, and if you tried, say, maybe losing weight, or if you tried using a nasal strip to open your airways while you sleep, you could use this to determine if those methods worked. In the future, with this system, we would hope to implement this application on iOS. We chose Android Studio because it was the easiest thing to work with. It did not require a developer's license, which costs money. And I feel like it's a lot more expandable to other devices, whereas iOS is just one platform. However, in the future, we would like to implement on iOS to cover all bases. We would like to implement a singular PCB design. Our prototype is built using components that we've sourced from each other. And it works fine. However, in order to create a more cohesive package, we would like to implement all of the portions of the sensor circuit into one PCB and put it on something that could be potentially adhered to the face or a face mask or something that looks a little more presentable and that is safe for the user to use. We would like to implement better battery life. Currently, our application, as been said, or our sensor can last for around 10 hours or more while recording. However, it would be more ideal if we could optimize battery usage in order to get maybe 3 or 4 nights of usage out of it. So that way you don't have to charge it every single day. We would like to improve the system's noise filtering system. So right now, as it stands, we only use a linear software filter, meaning that we only take data within certain thresholds and determine if you're snoring based on those thresholds. We would like to implement some sort of smart snoring algorithm using machine learning or vector analysis. So that way, A, we can more accurately classify snoring sounds versus ambient noise or any other sort of auxiliary noises. And we can also use vector space analysis to potentially distinguish your snoring patterns, the user's snoring patterns, from say their partners in their bed. Because if they snore as well, then there's a potential for the device to actually pick up on that. So hopefully in the future, we will be able to get these things in.